But coming up next, an important issue, Alzheimer's disease. New research out showing just how devastating it can be.
And we'll talk with a doctor about this disease and the new research and why those numbers are going up and what can be done.
And now, Fox 9 News at 5.
Back on Fox 5, and we're going to talk about really disturbing news and just how underreported Alzheimer's disease could be in the deaths in older Americans.
Yeah, a new study suggesting it is the third leading cause of death now. That's after heart disease and cancer. However, the CDC says that Alzheimer's disease is the sixth leading cause of death. The new research is in the American Academy of Neurology. And joining us here tonight, Dr. Ben Beckler with the University of Minnesota to talk about this. Can you explain why we're seeing the higher numbers, why this new research points to that?
You bet, Kelsey. First and foremost, the research really highlights something that the scientific community has speculated for many, many years, and that is Alzheimer's needs to be listed at a higher level as the major cause of mortality. Again, and we're seeing that from 6 to 3 in this major study. Mm-hmm. Why is the question? Well, death certificates really come into play here. Often a death certificate, we list the immediate cause of death, mm-hmm. like cardiac arrest, for mm-hmm. example. But that doesn't take into account a disease process that takes a 10 years or more, which may be the true attributable cause and event here. Mm-hmm. So this study followed patients backing up 8 years at a minimum, and then followed them before the diagnosis of Alzheimer's, and then looked at the cause of death later and attributed it back to their original diagnosis.
That makes sense.
You know, more than 5 million people in the U.S. are estimated to have Alzheimer's, and we know that the deaths from this disease have gone down because of better treatment and better understanding, mm-hmm. but the numbers seem to keep climbing. Is that because of better ways of diagnosing, or what's going on?
I think the answer is multifactorial. Number one, people are living longer on average. They're living longer with chronic disease. Doctors are getting better at diagnosing. But also there's a whole host of lifestyle factors that come into play as well. So it truly is a puzzle piece, a puzzle with many, many pieces.
Mm. Yeah, it's puzzling and scary. You know, what's out there for people who are suffering from Alzheimer's right now?
The most important thing for patients and their families and caregivers to know is they're not alone. In terms of resources, there are many. It's being connected and plugged in that is the most important step. First and foremost, working closely with a patient's primary care physician is critical. They can help coordinate care, getting in close, and of course under close care of a neurologist, plugging into support groups, appropriate medications. Again, if appropriate, there's significant debate on some of the medications, but it's more addressing really this holistic approach and a multifaceted support system for not only patients, but the caregivers.
Is another thing getting over that hurdle of just saying, you know what, I might have an issue here, because when it comes to so many diseases, for all of us, we're kind of in denial. This couldn't mm-hmm. happen to me. This isn't really happening here. Yet there's something in the back of your mind that you might be suspicious about your parent or a loved mm-hmm. one. Mm-hmm. Taking that first step, because isn't getting an early diagnosis much more beneficial?
Absolutely. And this really comes into play when we think about annual exams, keeping close touch with your primary care physician and having the family a part of that. It is very, very critical to have early diagnosis so we can provide maximum therapy and cares. And that starts early on. Again, Alzheimer's, we think about age and genetics as major risk factors, but as well, lifestyle. We know that major chronic diseases, and Alzheimer's would fall into this, these can be preventable. Research suggests that 70% of chronic diseases can be prevented through lifestyle intervention. Mm. So starting early, and that's where a lot of the research is today, of course in treatment, but also in prevention.
All right. Well, thank you very much. Great insight. And of course, we want to do all we can to learn about this topic. Dr. Ben Beckler with the University of Minnesota, thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, all right. You know, we talk more and more about it these days.